Engineering, I'm Alan. Today's video we'll go back to some basics. I picked up this set of gauge blocks, so what I will do is have a look at these, discuss how they're used, how you set up micrometers, and basically it's a bit back to basics. I picked this set of gauge blocks up. They cost £40, and I just thought I'd explain a bit about the gauge blocks to people who've probably never seen them before, or haven't been in engineering very long, or are just starting. These are gauge blocks, or slip gauges, or Joey blocks, or Johansen blocks. The name doesn't really matter that much. They were first made by Carl Johansen, who invented this gauge block set, and they were patented on the 2nd of May 1901 in Sweden. There are different types of gauge blocks depending on the accuracy of the set and the accuracy needed. This set, if you look here, it says the grade for workshop. You can also get an inspection grade, and it says it's international inch, obviously they're in inches, and it's got here a temperature of 68 degrees Fahrenheit. And what that means is when these are 68 degrees Fahrenheit, that is a temperature to give you the correct size. Now the correct size might not be what's on the block here, but it should be related back to the calibration certificate that came with the blocks. And on that certificate you'll have the size that the block should be and the size that the block is actually at 68 degrees Fahrenheit. What do you do with these blocks? Well, you can use them for checking things like your micrometers, your digital readouts, your scales on the lathe, if you've got digital readouts on the lathe, that they are exactly reading what you think they're reading. These are just steel blocks, hardened, ground, and the faces are lapped. You can see on these, they look wet. They have actually got a layer of oil, and I think there's some grease on there, mainly to stop the faces going rusty. So you can see it's got 0.6 inch. It says matrix on there. These have got here Coventry gauge and tool company, and the number here of the set. I've had this off to see if there was a calibration certificate under there or a date or anything. There's nothing on them to say how old they are. They look little used, so that indicates to me that we're either used as a setting set for setting micrometers in a workshop or checking something, but not used for every day. Set of steel blocks, different sizes, they go from 0.05, these are all inches, 0.1 and a tenth up to 9 tenths, then you've got 100 and a thou up to 19 thou, then you've got 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 up to 0.9, then you've got 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch and a 4 inch. And these two are 0.1 protective slips. The protective slips are to put on the end of your build of blocks to reduce the wear to the set. There are different size sets. You can get like a half set, and you can get sets that have got more blocks in than this. But this is just a basic set. Each set of blocks should have a calibration certificate showing the tested size of each block and the error of each block. Now, I haven't got a certificate with these, and for me it's not worth paying to get a certificate because it would be quite expensive. I don't need a calibration certificate because I've not had any slip gauges up to now, and this is far better accuracy than what I've had in the past, so at least now I can check my micrometers. And if you look at a slip gauge or gauge block, it has on it the size. These are the faces that you use. You must clean the faces before you ring them together. And the way you ring them together is put them 90 degrees, turn them together, move them in line, and that should hold. That will stay on there showing that it's been ringed correctly. If it's a worn set or there's something wrong, they won't hold together. They're not magnetic. The reason why that's holding is that the gauge blocks hold together due to the fine finish on the surface. Each surface is ground and lapped perfectly flat, I'll start building up the size 1.5748. So you start with the smallest number first. You can see from this set at the back here, it goes up in tenths of a thou. So we'll start with the 8 tenths, which is that one. So we've got the 8. Now we want 4 thou, which is the second row here. These are in thous. Here's the 4 thou. So we've got the 4. Now we want the 7. There it is here, 0.17. And now we should have the half inch, but we don't use the half inch because we've got 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. So to get the half inch, we need the 0.2, which is here, 0.2. So all those add up to 0.5748. And to get the inch, we can just take the inch block, which gives us 1.5748. So we fit these together. There we have the build up. See, they're all stuck together. That build up gives us 1.5748. Now, if you have a calibration certificate with your set, you can check the accuracy of this stack by adding the errors together from the calibration certificate. The calibration certificate should give you each block listed, what it should read and what the deviation is from the stated size. Normally the deviation will be a minus from the original size because the blocks do wear out. I think it would be quite rare to find a block that was oversized. So assuming that your calibration certificate gave you this, that the 1.1008 had an error of minus 00001, and the other blocks that we've used to build up this size 1.5748 had these errors, you can add the errors together and that would give you an error of 00014. Now if your accuracy needs to be spot on, you can add these up, and when you know that you're an error of a tenth, you could change your first slip gauge for the next one up, providing you know what the error is. Maybe the next one up has got an error of 0.1 again. By changing that for the 9, you'd then only be 0.00005 out. But you're getting into figures now. To get the accuracy here, you need to control the temperature, and obviously with temperature variation the slip gauges will expand and contract, and it's surprising how much they do expand and contract just by holding them in your hand for a few seconds.
You'll probably make them expand.
Now I've got a selection of micrometers here. This is the one I use mainly on the lathe. This is a 1-2. I'll use a 1-inch slip gauge. We'll just check this micrometer with the slip gauge. Now I think you might just be able to see that this is actually reading about a thou down on what it should be. Now I had no way of testing this micrometer. I've been using it for years. See how this is. Use a ratchet. This is actually half a thou. That size there is 1.5 inches. And you can see that on there. So considering that one hasn't been checked for about 30 years, it's not too bad. Now another problem you get with your micrometer if you're using it for lathe work all the time, and you do quite a bit, is that your anvil, which is this part here, will wear like this. So you will end up with a dip in the middle where you're constantly measuring over round bars. So what I used to do was once a year, because I was using it every day,
we would lap the faces of the micrometer to make sure they were square and flat to take out any error we were getting because of a worn anvil. We did this with a block of, I think it was a cast iron block about half inch thick with little grooves cut into it, and you drip the micrometer onto it, rub it up and down, and it would slowly take off any wear. To adjust the micrometer, you take your spanner, which you should have been supplied with the micrometer. If you turn it over on the back, you can see a small hole there. This spanner just fits into that hole, and you turn the body of the micrometer so that the datum line lines up with your zero when you've got your slip gauges in.
And that's how you reset the zero.
This is a combination micrometer. It gives inches here on this barrel, and on the back one is metric. And if you look at the, let's turn it around that way. If you look at the barrel here, you can see it's got going round on a spiral the metric size. So when this lines up with that line, you know you've got 10 millimetre. That's a micrometer with both Imperial and metric on. The only difference is on the Imperial, one division is 20 thou, not 25 thou. That's made by Shardlow Micrometers of Sheffield.
Hope you found that interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.